So the first problem gives us h of x equals 3x cubed plus 2 to the x and asks us to find h inverse of 20. Now, we're not going to be able to algebraically find an inverse function for this, but it didn't ask us to. It actually only asked us to find h inverse of 20. Now remember, with this notation, h inverse is an inverse function, h to the negative 1, and if 20 is an input to h inverse, it's an output to h of x. So what we're being asked to solve is where 3x cubed plus 2 to the x is equal to 20. We're going to do that with the graphing calculator. So let's take a look. So we bring up our graphing calculator, and first thing we'll do is we'll put in our function for y1. So 3x cubed plus 2 to the x. Oops. 2 raised to the x. And on our next line, we'll go down and we'll actually put in the output that we want. Now, if we just graph the two together, we really don't see a whole lot. There's our function, but we don't see the other one because, remember, we gave it an output of 20, and right now we're in a standard window. So we're going to need our y max to be big enough to see that. So let's go down and change our y max to 25, and now let's see what we see when we graph. So first we get our function, and then we've put in a horizontal line every place where the output is 20. So that intersection is the value we're looking for. So we can do second, calculate, and we want the intersection. Now it's just going to ask us which two curves. The first curve is our function, so that's fine. Second curve is where y is 20. And now we get our intersection when it says guess. And we get an intersection of 1.7684857. That is our solution. So when we go to write up our solution, we can actually say h inverse of 20 is about 1.7685. We use the squiggly equals because it's not exactly equal because we did round that answer off. Let's do the same thing with the next problem. K of x equals x to the fifth plus x plus 1. A fifth degree polynomial is not a trivial function to find an inverse function for. But again, we weren't asked to. We were asked to find k inverse of 100. So we want to find where our function has an output of 100. So once again, we'll put each of these in our graphing calculator. And what you'll notice is I've deselected the first two in case I want to use them later. These two are selected. You can do that by putting your cursor on the equal sign and hitting enter. Now, I have the same window we had for the last function, and let's see what we get. So we do see our fifth degree polynomial. We don't see 100. So once again, we have an issue of our window not being tall enough. We need to make our y max higher, bigger than 100, so let's do 120. Let's go back to our graph and see if we see our intersection. You may have to play around with your window a little bit to get this intersection. There's nothing wrong with that. Lastly, we do our second calculate, intersect, first curve, enter, second curve, enter, guess, enter, and there's our solution, 2.494, which again we can write up as k inverse of 100 equals 2.494. Again, we use the approximate because we've rounded off and it's not exact. So that's how we can solve for a particular value using our calculator. It's particularly when it's difficult to find the inverse function.